Before I start, I would like to thank the organizers for organizing, for inviting me to give this lecture in the European Society of Medicine, Vienna, Austria. I'm going to talk about and to speak about a comparison of vascular tissues of vascular differentiation in normal and tumorous tissues of plants and human beings. My name is Roni Aloni, and I am from Tel Aviv University, working on plants. And there are two objectives to my lecture. One of them, the first, is the initial recognition of the differentiation and regeneration of vascular tissues in plants. Here you see vascular regeneration. And I would like to stimulate you to have a stimulating creative thinking in human research inspired by findings from the plant world. The first slide that I show you now, I show you a very large magnification of a young leaf. And in this leaf, we see the sites where a hormone is produced. The hormone is called auxin. It moves from the site of production, and along the pathway, it induces the vascular tissues. Under a lower magnification, we see part of the leaf. We see here a hair, we call it a trichome, that produces the hormone, and this hormone induces the vein that brings water and sugar to this location. To get more information on what I'm going to talk today, you can read the information and much more about it in a new book that I just published in 2021. The book entitles Vascular Differentiation and Plant Hormone, and it covers many aspects of vascular differentiation and how these vascular tissues are induced by hormones. When we come back to a young leaf, here we can see a very young leaf in high magnification. We see in the lobe, and a lobe is like a growing finger. In the lobe, we can see the production or the synthesis of the hormonal signal that moves down and induces the vascular tissue. At this stage, the vascular tissues end here. They will continue to differentiate. And here we can see a day later how the vessels are coming to the surface of the leaf. When we watch leaves, we can see an asymmetry between the right side and the left side, which is similar to blood vessels in the right hand that are different from the pattern formed on the left hand. This pattern of asymmetry indicates hormonal control that is independent of genetics and is formed by hormonal signals flowing in random routes. In the human body, we can see here a hand and a leg. We see the fingers and the veins go, they start from the fingers, and according to my understanding, from my research on plants, the stimulus to form blood vessels is produced in the fingertips here and in the legs in these sites. When I cut a bundle. This is a vascular bundle of many vessels. When I cut it and I apply auxin, I apply the stimulus that induces the vascular system, I apply it in this side, what happens is that the signal moves down and it concentrates in this site because the system is damaged. And then it's the hormones start to move around the wound and induces the vascular tissues that connect the two cut parts, creating a bypass that resumes the flow of nutrients and water around the wound. This is much better than a bypass surgery or cardiac catheterization. In mature organs, like what we see here in the photo, this is the site of the wound for our location. And we can induce very wide new veins, which we cannot do it in very young tissues. In this experiment that we see just now, it was done by Zvi Zaks. He showed the relationship between vascular tissues, and the new induced one. When he cut all the tissue above this site and didn't apply any hormone, but applied the hormone only in this site, the hormone moved towards the available vascular tissue and induces veins or vessels that were that connected directly. However, when he added the hormonal signal also into the pre-existing vascular system together with the side application, what we can see that the movement of hormone in the already differentiated tissue prevented direct connection, and the new vein differentiated started to connect much lower. And in an extreme case, when he added more hormonal signal to the available system and applied the hormone from the side, we can see that the new veins didn't connect to the pre-existing vascular system that was loaded with the hormone. Now I would like to show you or give you some information about tumors. And of course, I'm speaking about plant tumors. This is a tomato plant that I induce a tumor. And the tumor is a 2 months old tumor, a typical one. And we can see naturally tumors on vines, on olives, and many other plants. You can see the tumors, how they are different and they are very clear. And the tumors that I just show you are induced by a special bacterium called Agrobacterium tumefaciens. This bacterium has a special plasmid, a long one. We call it TI plasmid, which is tumor-inducing plasmid. Part of it has a part that we call tDNA. On this part, there are hormones that are genes that induce auxin, that produce auxin and cytokine, two important hormones. Once the tDNA enters into the plant genome, you can see that it is incorporated into into the DNA of the plant, then the cells start to produce auxin and cytokinin, two major hormones, and also opins. And opins are carbohydrates that are used by the bacterium. The plant cannot use them, and the cells, the plant cells, produce the hormones in a very high level. Therefore, the tumor starts to develop, and here is the tumor that was induced by the Agrobacterium tumefaciens. And when we make a longitudinal cut in a tumor, this is a 2 months old tumor, we can see that the hormone is produced in a random pattern. This random pattern produces also vascular tissues in random patterns. For example, here in another tumor, we can see that from the vascular tissues of the stem of the plant, different patterns of vascular tissues develop, and they are induced by the auxin hormone that was synthesized in these locations. This is a schematic pattern to show you that we have generally two patterns, one like trees and like one like ovals, like an egg. These are the typical ones. And in between, we have very gentle connections of vascular tissues. The question is, are these vascular tissues in random pattern functional? And the answer, yes, because if this is a stem and this is a very young tumor, this is a 3 week old tumor, I applied here a dye, a red dye, and you can see that the dye goes into the tumor. And in an older a tumor, this is a 2 months old tumor, the red dye entered into the gall until the surface of the gall. Here another demonstration. In this case, we applied a blue color that went into the gall, and the bundles, the vascular tissues are, although they have a random pattern, they are functional. Again, we can see here a tumor, a 2 months old tumor, a typical one. I'm going to show you soon a cross section below the tumor to show you the effect of the tumor. The tumor induces narrow, stimulate the differentiation of narrow vessels. We shall see it soon. And these narrow vessels limits the water that comes up. So the tumor enjoyed more water than the young leaves, and this is part of the damage of the tumor. And we found that plants that have low sensitivity to another hormone, this is to ethylene, which is a hormonal gas, the tumor, if the tumor starts to develop, it will degenerate. This is a tumor that developed on a NR. NR, it's the never ripe line that is that have very low sensitivity to ethylene. And the tumor that started to develop degenerate, and there is no damage to the vascular system. I will show you soon. This is the first, is a cross section below a tumor in a plants that have normal sensitivity to ethylene. And you see that the vessels are narrow, very few, but narrow vessels. And in the plant that is not sensitive to ethylene or very low sensitivity, we have the plant produces many vessels that are wide. So the leaves, the young leaves above the tumor are very well watered, and there is no problem for leaf and fruit development. And here are, these are two plants. On the left side is the normal tomato with a tumor that developed here. On the right side, it's a never ripe. It's a line that has very low sensitivity to ethylene. Although the tumor is relatively large, the plant, the leaves are well watered because the vascular system is wide, many vessels of wide diameter. And if 2 days, this was discovered on the weekend, when in two, this is the effect of 2 days without irrigation, the normal plants that have normal sensitivity to ethylene dry, the leaves dry out. And those with the tumor on the plant that is not sensitive to ethylene and have a very wide vessels, they didn't suffer from this 2 day, from this 2 day without irrigation. So in practice, we came to a solution, and there is no crop damage to plants that are not sensitive to ethylene. And we graft today branches of plants that have high quality fruits. And what we find, what we get is a high quality crop, and that obtain in plants with cancer that have a low sensitivity to the hormone ethylene, and there is no damage to their fruit. The fruit is large, nice developed fruit with high sugar, and this is today the main way to overcome the cancer problem that if we don't treat it, there is a lot of agricultural damage. Coming back to plants, to animals, this is a book on AIDS, cancer, and arthritis. And what we can see here that in the center, there is a photo of a tumor on plants. And the idea is we can learn and we can use the knowledge gained from plant research to cure people with tumors. I'm showing you a photo of from a human being. You can see a young tumor that goes on the surface. It induces many veins that differentiate from the periphery into the tumor. There is tumor angiogenesis, something that is known for many, many years. And I'm going back to plants. And in plants, what we found that when a tumor develops, in the first 2 weeks, there is a very high peak of jasmonic acid. Jasmonic acid is a plant hormone that activates protective responses in plants. And when a plant is attacked by bacterium at the early stages of tumor development, the jasmonic acid fights against the tumor and can slow down or even prevent tumor development. With this idea, at Tel Aviv University, another lab in the medical school is by Eliezer, they studied the effect of the hormonal of the jasmonic acid on selective on two more lines and the lines of from the same people, from the same person, normal and tumor, a combination of in vitro studies on normal cells and tumorous cells. And what they found, a selective recognition of the jasmonic acid that attacks the mitochondria of human cancer cell, striking and killing them selectively. The mitochondria are damaged and the plants start to die. And this effect can be seen within less than 24 hours. And it is already used in some hospitals. Another method to fight tumors is by antibiotics, and the antibiotics also target mitochondria. And what we can see that FDA approved antibiotics target mitochondria of cancerous cells, and it eradicates cancer stem cells. So antibiotics approved to treat human, destroyed human cancer tumors. And this was discovered about 6 years ago, but people didn't understand the reason. And I gave lectures in a different university, speaking about hormones, about bacteria, and how they induce or affect plant cancer. But antibiotics that kills plant cancer also kills, they kill the bacteria that induces cancer in plants. They also kill the cancer cells in human, in humans. And here it's a recent study from 2019 that show that the microbiome that are inside the cancerous cells, they protect the cancerous cells from the immune system. The bacteria entered also into the immune system, and then the immune system cannot fight and cannot destroy the cancer cells, the tumor. And here, for example, a recent study from 2020, and here you see a high magnification of a cancer cell of breast cancer. And you can see in the cancer cells, you can see bacteria one and two. This is here you can see on the right side, a higher magnification of the same cell. And you can see a bacterium in the tumorous cell, and here another bacterium. And this bacteria that are in the cancer cells, they also penetrate into the immune cells. And once they are in the immune cells, they neutralize their effect they neutralize the response of the immune cells that cannot fight again the cancer cells. And in the study that you can see here also, it's from 2020, you can see different tumors from different places in the human body. And what was found, that each tumor has a different type of bacterium. And there are specific bacteria in the different cancers. Therefore, there is need for different types of antibiotics to eradicate these bacteria in the different in the specific tumor in order to kill the bacteria and then also to clean the immune system, the cells of the immune system that then start to fight the bacteria, and in the early stages they can eliminate the cancer. For more information specifically on vascular tissues and tumor, you can get also much more information than I can give in only a short half an hour lecture. Go and read in my new book, Vascular Differentiation and Plant Hormones, a book that was just published in 2021. Thank you very much to listen to my lecture, and I'm ready to answer questions and to hopefully to clear points that were not, that didn't get enough time in my lecture. Thank you.